Hey, what up? My name's OP from Serato, and today I'm gonna walk you through making a boom bap hip hop style beat, kinda in the vibe of a Mac Miller, Nas, or even Pete Rock. I'm using our beat making software, Serato Studio, which is completely free for you to download now. It comes built in with a ton of free samples, which I'm gonna use to make this beat so you can follow along. Let's check it out.
When you open up Serato Studio, you'll see this welcome screen with a few options to get started. You can select make a new beat, a DJ edit, or choose to make a beat by genre. Since we're making hip hop, let's click on that. So now that we're in Serato Studio, we can see the beats per minute or the BPM, which is set to 95, which is a common tempo for boom bap hip hop. You can easily change the BPM here, but since 95 works for hip hop, let's leave it like that. Serato Studio comes with a bunch of free drum kits and samples built into the software. Since we selected the hip hop template, we've been given a hip hop kit which gives us 8 drum sounds. If you want to switch out your drum kit, go to the Drum tab and then go to All Drum Kits to browse through them. Today we're going to use the Live Break Drum Kit. Just click and drag to load the kit up, or hold Command plus left arrow. Now let's get a drum pattern going. The grid on the right side is called a sequencer, and it's used to create patterns from the sounds loaded on the left deck. There's a really handy feature in Serato Studio called Make Drums, which gives you randomized drum patterns to get started. First, let's increase the length of our sequence so that the loop isn't too short. Now we can press Make Hip Hop, and a preset pattern will appear. Just keep clicking on it until you find something that you like, and then make little adjustments by adding or taking away notes in the sequencer. To play back your drum beat, press the play button or just press the space bar. Swing mimics the natural sound of a real human drummer, and it's a popular effect in boom bap hip hop. So let's add in some swing now. You can adjust the velocity or volume of each drum hit to make it sound a little more live and dynamic. This is usually done in boom bap hip hop by simply lowering the volume of each second hi-hat. So let's go ahead and select these hi-hats that we want to adjust by holding Shift and then clicking on them. Then we can hold down the Command key and click and drag one of the notes to lower all the volumes a little bit. With the drums all taken care of, it's time to add a sample in. Go to the Audio Samples tab in your library, and then go to All Sample Loops Crate. There's a ton of free sample loops already built into Serato Studio, so browse through them until you find something that you like. I'm gonna go with the Soul Snap sample. So let's load it up by clicking Add Sample over here, and dragging it over to the sample deck. We can see these 8 pads are filled in again, this time with different chops across the audio sample. We call these markers cue points. If you need to, click Find Samples again to find new cue points. Play around with your cue points until you find a nice rhythm to record in. Make sure your sample mode is set to trigger mode. This is going to keep your samples playing after you trigger it from the keyboard. Now you'll notice that the sample loop sounds in time with my drums. This is because Serato Studio automatically syncs your sample's BPM and key to your whole project, so all of your layers should sound good together. When you're working out your sample sequence, play it over your drum beat. This will make the sample sit more naturally into the other layers. To record a sequence in real time, you can either play it in real time on your laptop keyboard, or you can paint in the notes into your sequencer. It's up to you, whichever you prefer. I'm gonna record it live. You should now be starting to get an idea of the volume of your drums versus the other layers in your track. We can hear that the drums are a little too loud, so let's turn them down a little bit. So now that there's a sample pattern, let's try adding in some effects. This is where you can shape each sound just like you like it to add your own personal flavor. Open the effects panel and you'll see 6 effect slots. These left 3 slots here are for adding in effects to individual samples or cue points. The other 3 on the right are adding effects to the whole deck. I'm gonna add in limiter squeeze, dry reverb, and hard sidechain. We're adding effects to the sample, so let's make sure that the sample deck is open, not your drums. And you can adjust the depth for each effect, like this. Serato Studio also comes with a load of different high-quality instruments for free, including bass, strings, and keys. For boom bap hip hop, pads, string-based keys, and pluck sounds are very popular sounds to use. Today, we're gonna add in some guitar. So again, click Add Instruments here, then go to the guitar crate inside the instruments. I'm going to select and drag the rhythm guitar. Now, if you've never played an instrument or don't know music theory, Serato Studio takes care of that for you with the playing key mode. What this does is it only gives you the notes in the key of your project, so you can play in chords or melodies and everything will stay in key. For this part, you're just going to play around with the instrument until you find a pattern that you like, and then from there, either record or paint in with your mouse. I'll record it in. If you've made a mistake in your recording, you can always correct it in the sequencer here. I'm going to make a few adjustments with my mouse. I want to change the guitar sound up, so I'm going to adjust the attack and the release here. And then again, add some effects. For the effects, I'm going to go with the flex flanger and the light tail reverb to give the sound some more character. And again, remember, how you use the effects is all up to you. There's no hard or fast rules. Now that we have a nice loop here, we can use it as a foundation to build the track. This loop that we're in, we call a scene. What we're gonna do is copy the scene and make a few variations out of it to create our basic song structure, including verse, chorus, and outro. When structuring your song, you want to think about the purpose of each section and how it should serve your track. The first scene has all layers, so we can call that our hook or our chorus. Using this copied scene, let's make an intro with just the sample, which will create a lead-in. To remove layers, I'll just clear my drums and guitar decks by using the clear button. If you delete the whole deck, it will remove the whole deck from your scenes, so just use the clear button instead for creating variations. Let's select our first scene to copy again, but this time we'll just remove the guitar and keep the drums. This will be our verse. Now that we have our basic song selections, let's put it in order. Go to the Song View tab here in your library. Now you can drag and drop your scenes in order. As your song plays, you'll see a visual representation here of the master as a colored waveform. Clicking the master track will show us a larger view and let us add effects to the whole song. Adding mastering effects like brightener EQ, master compression, and limiter will really help your track sound more full and professional. And when you're happy with the way it sounds, you can export it as an MP3.
Nice work. You just made a dope hip-hop track. And if you haven't gotten to yet, go download Serato Studio for free at the link below. And if you're already using Studio, check out the other tutorials to dive into making even more genres like trap, EDM, or even house. If you're looking for more samples to use, we've got a bunch of sound packs for free to download at the website via the links below. Go get busy.